Hi everyone, this is Larilyn with Houseofachoti Design, bringing another pattern review on my Sunday sewing shenanigans. So today I'll be reviewing the McCalls pattern 7789. It's a attached bodice to palazzo pants, aka jumpsuit, and my version is right behind me. Isn't she lovely? Let me give her a little spin so you can actually see the details on this cute little jumpsuit. All right, so I've chosen the Ankara print. It's so vibrant, and you know, the detail, I was a little worried because African Ankara prints are always so busy, but the end result, it's just priceless, usually. So with this M7789 pattern, basically you can create your own look. There are three different bodices that you can choose from. And looking at the instruction layout that comes with, you know, all of your patterns, you want to pull that out. You can choose from the tie front bodice. There was a cutout front bodice, and there was also a knotted front bodice. And I actually chose the cutout bodice here. So you've got the bodice top, you've got this little midriff section that's also attached, and you have the wide leg palazzo pants. There's also deep pockets, and who doesn't love a deep pocket to put all of your stuff, like I do, inside? And that's a great detail feature as well that I loved about this pattern. So basically, I started by laying out my Ankara print, which is about a 45-inch fabric cut, right sides together. And I would lay each piece out, of course, along your lengthwise grain or the selvage grain. For the view that I chose, the bodice, cutout bodice with the pants, I needed for the pants, I started with the pants first. You needed pieces 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. And you want to make sure, ask me how I know, you want to make sure you cut out. If you look at the cutting instructions, you have the right side of the pattern, the wrong side of the pattern, the right side of the fabric, and the wrong side of the fabric. For pieces 9 and 12, which are your pants, you want to cut out two pieces, of course, for the front and two for the back. You want to make sure you pay attention to that cutting layout. You want to lay out piece 9 pattern side up and pattern side down, as well as 12 pattern side up, pattern side down. Don't be overzealous because of your sewing skills and just go fast forward without reading those cutting layouts, okay? Don't do what I did. So I did a mock-up though. I always start with a mock-up with a muslin just to make sure the fit's going to be right. And because this pattern is pretty much based on someone that's probably around 5'7 or 5'8, and I'm about 5'3, I typically cut off about 4 to 5 inches, you know, from the leg. And I of course made a mock-up to make sure it fit the way that, you know, I would want it to fit me, and it fits fabulous. All right, so let's get back into this pattern review. So once I actually did the cutting layout for my pants, I moved on to the sewing instructions. And this pattern is so detailed, it's so straightforward of what to do to make this, of course, a custom garment to your liking based on choosing the pants with the skirt, you know, the three different types of bodices or what have you. So basically, you know, you start with the pants front. One thing you want to be mindful of, if you look at step 4 on the pattern instructions, and I'll show you here, this is where you're attaching that pocket side front to the pocket front, to the pocket. You want to make sure that you actually take the, you want to fold that pocket to the back, basically to the wrong side of the garment, right? Because if you look at step 3 to step 4, that could be a little confusing when you read it, because you attach the front pocket first, or the pocket piece first. Once you turn that to the back of the garment, then you'll attach right sides together. So the side front to the front, okay? And basically, that was the only part that I thought that could be a little tricky. So once you go past that part, you want to make sure you're matching up all your symbols and, you know, notches and circles, because it's very detailed, very straightforward with that, to get everything to line up and for it to hang correctly. All right, so moving on, of course, what was the next thing that could be a little tricky here? You don't want to overlook on step number 8, the circle. There's a circle on the back piece. When you're sewing the inner leg seam or the crotch portion, I started basically on the right side of the inseam and sewed all the way up to that circle. You also want to make sure, depending on your crotch depth, hoping that you took those measurements before you sewed the garment and matched all that to the pattern, to make sure that the inseam or the crotch portion fits you, so it's not hanging too far down and looking too loose. Or if you have a larger derriere, you want to make sure that you take accurate measurements for the crotch length and the crotch depth as well, and compare that to your pattern to make those adjustments first prior to sewing this up. Okay, so that's important. And then of course step 8 is making sure that you go back in and do an extra layer of stitching for reinforcement within that inseam. Okay, so basically the only pieces that needed to be interfaced were the midriff portions, which are here, and you'll have two midriff or midsection pieces that'll attach between the bodice and the pant. You want to interface only one of those. And of course the other one you'll be using on top of that. And if you actually look at step, 11, it says the interdrift midriff sections will be used for lining. So it's the non-interface portion that you'll use to attach also to the pant, okay? So then as you move forward to, step 13, basically you're attaching the midriff section to the pant, and that was pretty straightforward as well. Now, once you get past step 16, again, I actually went backwards because I did the pants first and then I attached the bodice last. But backing up a little bit, going back to step 17 here, once you have your midriff and your pants attached, you also want to make sure that you do your underlining, your understitching, properly to keep that inner lining on the inside, from rolling. And your top stitching just for the aesthetics of the garment. All right, so the next thing that I did, going back to sewing instructions, I chose the cutout bodice. So you want to move over, don't avoid the stay stitching, that's important, as well as it's showing in step 1 underneath the cutout front bodice. Stay stitching is basically just a regular machine stitch that you want to use along necklines, areas where you don't want it to stretch out, basically. So I did stay stitching there, so don't skip out on that. And then steps basically 2 through 6 or 2 through 5 are basically just telling you to put your front portion of the bodice, which is here, that's sewn to the side portion of the bodice, the side front here, and then you have the side back, and then you have the back bodice. So once all of those pieces are sewn together, the straps, make sure that you measure where you would want your straps to sit. So basically, if the bodice comes to about here is where it starts and your strap starts about here, you want to measure that length from here to where you want it to stop back here. I actually added about 2.5 inches to the pattern strap, and make sure when you're reading the pattern instructions, one thing that could be possibly a little confusing is when you insert the strap inside of the lining, you want this strap to sit between the face fabric and the lining fabric. So basically, when you're stitching that bodice together, you don't want to sew all the way across the top because you have to leave room for the strap to go in, okay? So that could be a little tricky when you're reading that as well. And basically, as I got closer to, redesigning this to my liking a little bit differently, even though the pattern was great the way it is, I just started with the pants first, where it instructs you to start with the bodice first. So once everything was sewn separately, the pant now attached to the midriff, I then attached the bodice to everything else. I did some hand stitching on the inside. I also modified the bodice a little bit with a couple darts in the front because I didn't do any contouring prior with the pattern. So I added a couple darts in the front here of the bodice and a couple side darts on the side of the side front. And the only other modification I did here was the pleat effect in the front. I actually top stitched along the top portion. And if you go back to the pant pattern, it starts with number 9. When you're at step 1, right here for the pants, let me get on my tippy toes so you can see that. Sorry, people. Right there, I actually top stitched a little bit along the top portion of the pleat. And for me, I think it actually lies a little bit flatter along here. So I still have to hem the jumpsuit, but pretty much that is all. This pattern is so straightforward. It's a beautiful sew. Depending on, you know, what you like and what you don't like in terms of, you know, exposing shoulders or whatever, I think this is great summer with some sandals, you know, cute little heels. You could dress it up with that. Night on the town for dinner. If it's a cooler night, you could probably do like a little bolero jacket, you know, or something. You know, I love my bolero jackets. I think they go with any and everything, morning till night. But anyway, that's my review for McCall 7789. Hopefully that was helpful. You know, basically I just cover some of the things that were tricky for me to help the next sewer, you know, make it easier, you know, for you. But I'll give you another quick look for my Oh So Fly in Dubai outfit number, is it 4 or 5? I think this is outfit number 5. I've been sewing so much. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Houseofachoti Design. Please follow me on Instagram at Houseofachoti, Facebook, Houseofachoti Design and Gifts. Please like, share, subscribe. Hit the bell for notifications. You'll get my videos as they come up, usually on Sundays. Sometimes I do tidbits of sewing things throughout the week as well, depending on how busy I am and working on, you know, orders coming in. I'm starting to take some of those custom orders for clients, and just depending on what I get to. So keep watching, trying to grow this channel as I'm doing something new after 20 years of leaving medicine. As I am saying, I'm leaving medicine. I've left medicine. We'll see if I will permanently be gone from medicine. But as of now, I'm loving this fashion design and sewing. Houseofachoti Design, help me grow. Watch, doesn't cost you a thing, guys. Like, share, and subscribe on YouTube. I sure do appreciate your time for watching. Have a great Sunday. Bye.